Hello and a very good evening. It's 6:30 p.m. time for Verdict 2015 on Rajya Sabha Television with me, Frank Pereira. Here are this evening's Verdict headlines. Pulses prices becomes a poll issue in Bihar. Central ministers blame Chief Minister Nitish Kumar for the crisis. Nitish hits back, saying it was time the Prime Minister brought back the old days. Another day of hectic campaigning in Bihar. Actor-turned-politician Hema Malini addresses rally for the BJP. Nitish and Lalu also continue with their campaign trails. Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi to address rallies ahead of the third phase of polling in Bihar. Prime Minister to address rally in Patna and Rahul in West Champaran. And today the spotlight is on Vaishali, where the struggle continues to get basic amenities as voters continue to blame successive state governments. Well, after reservation, what has happened is the Dadri lynching and the cow slaughter, the rising pulse prices have now become a poll issue in Bihar as leaders try to pin the blame on their rivals. Facing flak for their absence from Delhi during the ongoing dal price crisis, Central Ministers Ram Vilas Paswan and Radha Mohan Singh chose to take the battle to the enemy camp from Bihar. Here's more.
With a finger on the pulse of voters, rival alliances in election-bound Bihar on Tuesday served each other liberal portions of blame for the rapidly vanishing pulses from the platter of the common man due to its soaring prices. The Food Minister Ram Vilas Paswan and the Minister of Agriculture Radha Mohan Singh chose to bat out of Bihar, where they have been for the last 2 months campaigning for the assembly elections. Addressing a joint press conference at the BJP office in Patna, the ministers, who are also lawmakers from Bihar, targeted political rival and Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar over the rise of dal prices.
तो उसको भी उस पत्र को भी उन्होंने रिस्पांस नहीं किया. कीमतें जो बिहार में बढ़ी है उसके लिए यदि कोई जिम्मेदार है तो नीतीश कुमार है.
आप स्टॉक लिमिट तय कीजिए. एसेंशियल कमोडिटी के एक्ट के तहत आपको कार्रवाई करने का अधिकार है, उसका उपयोग कीजिए. जो प्रिवेंशन ऑफ ब्लैक मार्केटिंग एक्ट है उसके अंतर्गत आप कार्रवाई कीजिए. एक भी कार्रवाई इन्होंने नहीं किया, उस दिशा में कोई कदम भी नहीं बढ़ाया.
As he came under attack, Nitish Kumar sought to turn the tables on the center for the skyrocketing pulse prices, this time hitting out at Modi over his अच्छे दिन comment and saying people wanted their पुराने दिन back.
लोगों के थाली से दाल गायब हुआ और लोगों के चित्त से भी ये बुरी तरह उतर गए हैं, इसलिए इनका कोई सगुफा काम करने वाला नहीं. लौटाने की जाए, काम करे, काम करना चाहिए. तिनको चिंता न सूखे की है, न दाल के महंगाई की है या अन्य महंगाई की है. लोग तो अब कहने लगे, लोग कहने लगे हैं कि मोदी जी अच्छे दिन अपने पास रखिए, पुराने दिन ही लौटा दीजिए.
अदर लीडर्स इन द ग्रैंड अलायंस वर आल्सो क्विक टू रिएक्ट.
दाल का प्रदेश में सब चीज हो गया, दाल के साथ साथ प्याज लहसुन मसाला. बाजार में देखते हो कोई परचेजर है, कैपेसिटी नहीं है.
भारत के वित्त मंत्री जी बयान दे रहे हैं कि पोर्ट्स पर दाल पड़ी हुई है, जबकि पोर्ट्स में दाल अगर है तो उसकी आप जानकारी लीजिए. पोर्ट एसोसिएशन में जो लोग काम करते हैं उन्होंने मना कर दिया कि साहब यहां पे कोई दाल है ही नहीं. इस कदर अगर वित्त मंत्री गुमराह करेंगे इस देश के लोगों को तो कैसे काम चलेगा. पूरे तरीके से भारतीय जनता पार्टी की मोदी सरकार असफल हुई है.
दाल के दाम सिर्फ बिहार में नहीं, दिल्ली से लेकर गुजरात तक आसमान छू रहे हैं. आज की तारीख में बिहार में दाल का दाम और गुजरात में दाल का दाम बराबर है. अगर नीतीश कुमार दोषी हैं तो आनंदी बहन दोष मुक्त कैसे हैं?
While a war of words broke out in Bihar, over 5,800 tons of pulses have been seized in 5 states during raids conducted on hoarders in the last few months. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Well, joining me for a chat right now, live from Patna in Bihar, is our correspondent Kriti Mishra. Well, Kriti, after the focus over the last few weeks has been, you know, reservation, the Dadri lynching and cow slaughter, the focus now seems to have shifted to the pulses prices issue now.
Absolutely, Frank. So the parties are sparring over the spiraling prices of pulse here. We actually saw how Union Minister Radhamohan Singh and also Ramvilas Paswan hit out at Nitish Kumar, and he said that it was because of him, because he failed to arrest the decline in dal production, and also he failed to act against hoarders and black marketers and did not even utilize the price stabilization fund given by the centre. On the other hand, Ramvilas Paswan was quick to prophesize that come November 8, prices of pulse in Bihar would plummet below 100 when the NDA would form government here. Of course, Nitish Kumar was also quick to give a rebuttal, and he said that prices of dal were equally high in the BJP rule states. He also said that forget Achhe Din, get back our Purane Din, and also said that Prime Minister Modi has always claimed na khaunga na khane dunga. So he used it for dal, and he said the Prime Minister is doing just the same. He is not letting people eat pulse. Of course, and also Lalu Prasad Yadav, a quintessential Lalu Prasad Yadav, in his quirky way said that he can no more afford to use the tagline ghar ki murgi dal barabar. And now Mahagathbandhan is out on the streets telling people that this time in Diwali, instead of giving dry fruits to their loved ones, they should rather give pulses, and that would be cherished and relished more. Of course, this sparring is continuing, but the burden is really on the common man. Frank.
All right, Kriti Mishra, we'll have to leave to that. Thank you so much for joining us there with those details from Bihar and putting things into perspective for us. In the meantime, let's go across to Dr. Shakil, political analyst who joins us from Bihar as well to talk about this particular issue. You know, Dr. Shakil, the focus now seems to have shifted on the prices of pulses, and we've seen that, you know, the chief minister and two union ministers are sparring with each other as far as the issue of price rise of pulses is concerned.
At least for a change during last month or so of electioneering, at least a real issue which touches the minds of the people, minds and hearts of the people, has been raised. Once again with one side blaming the other. But the moot question remains for the electorates that whosoever is responsible, either the central government or the state government, the prices of pulses should be within the limits of the reach of the common people. Now, this is common in election times that there are two political parties at the state and center, one blames the other. But the fact on the ground is that pulses across the country have become very costlier than even chicken in many places in the country. And this is also a fact that the state government has done precious little in nabbing the hoarders, who are one of the important reasons, the hoarding of the essential commodities. So both the state government and the central government have failed this time around to control the prices of the pulses. And that's what the common man on the street feels. I mean, the diatribe against each other for a scoring political point is fine. But ultimately, the result is that dal is still out of the reach of the common man.
Indeed, dal is out of the reach of the common man. But how big a poll issue do you think that this is going to be? Is it going to have any kind of bearing on the ground?
Of course, it will have price rise, unemployment, migration. These development issues, these issues related to governance, schools, hospitals, law and order, these are the issues, the roads, the connectivity, electricity. These are the issues on which the voters decide that which party they should vote for.
Indeed.
Unfortunately, during the first two rounds of the electioneering, these issues were sidelined by the main contenders for the power in this state, both by the NDA and by the Grand Alliance. But for now, some reason beyond their control, now these issues are propping him. And I think in coming days, many more issues which really matter to the electorates will have to be debated upon in the arena of electioneering.
All right, Dr. Shakil, do stay with us. Of course, I'm going to come back to you later on in the program for a reaction on another story that we're tracking here on Verdict 2015. For now, of course, it's time for a short break. On the other side, we'll take a look at some rallies by big wigs in Bihar. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Topics.
If you can facilitate the opening up and the expansion of the international border trade, you can add to the economy.
370 dhara jo hai, wo Jammu Kashmir ko mulk ke saath jode rakhti hai.
Candid confessions.
The Congress has not been able to communicate.
We have to revive our links with the masses.
World class healthcare is available to only a handful of people in this country.
Courting controversies.
A lot of leaders today think that they rule by divine right.
Now, media has become manageable.
Watch RSTV Engage Personalities to the Point. Every Wednesday, 10 p.m., Thursday, 1:30 and 5:30 p.m.
Welcome back. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. Well, Chief Minister Nitish Kumar campaigned in Bihar's Motihari today, attacking the BJP over the price rise of pulses. He said that the agriculture minister and the food minister are attacking a state chief minister over inflation in the country. He also criticized the BJP over the Dalits killing in Haryana. Yes, Bihar ko
kahiyega jangal raj, Haryana mein Dalito ko jalaya ja raha hai. Wahan hai inke hisab se mangal raj aur Bihar mein hai jangal raj. Isliye ye apmanit karne ke liye bolte hain.
Moving on now, addressing a rally in Bihar's Nalanda today, Lalu Prasad said that the Modi government only wants to disrupt the current reservation policy. He also said that the RJD-JDU combined will bring back the glorious days of Bihar. Meanwhile, BJP star campaigner and MP Hema Malini addressed a rally in Ara's Bhojpur area today. Continuing with the BJP's development call, Hema Malini said that Bihar is lagging behind and has become one of the backward states of the country. She urged the crowd to vote for development and elect a BJP-led government in Bihar.
भारत आगे बढ़ रहा है, आधुनिक भारत बनता जा रहा है और बिहार पिछड़ा बनता जा रहा है. आप लोग बस इसी स्थिति में रहना चाहेंगे? आगे बढ़ेंगे ना? इतने नौजवान हैं, यहाँ पे कोई कारखाना कुछ है आप लोगों के लिए, नौकरी के लिए, आमदनी के लिए? कुछ भी नहीं.
Let's go across to our guest, Dr. Shakil, political analyst from Bihar, who's still with us right now. Well, Dr. Shakil, as far as rallies are concerned, you know, the rallies continue. The BJP seems to be sticking to its development plank at the moment and trying to, you know, woo the youth of the state as well. And as far as the opposition is concerned, or rather the Grand Alliance is concerned, we've seen that the Grand Alliance is still sticking to some of those crucial issues like the Dalits being killed in Faridabad in Haryana. That issue was raised today sharply.
Yeah, you can see that the issue of debate is in electoral war is changing. The NDA is trying to attract youth. Youth constitute about 54% of the electorates in the state. So both the major alliances, be it NDA or Grand Alliance, is trying to woo. And that's why in that very popular Nitish Nishchay, what they Nitish described as 7-point charter of development of Bihar, there were too many things which he had offered to youth, like giving them unemployment allowance, giving them free Wi-Fi, giving them some loans, some credit cards, and so on and so forth. So now NDA is also coming and trying to woo the voters. But Nitish and Lalu knows pretty well that their best bet lies in keeping the issue of mandalization of politics alive. And that's why they will keep on harping on reservation, and they can get, if such incidents happen anywhere in the country, as recently happened in Haryana, where two Dalits were burnt. So they will try to make best out of it, to tell the people here, especially the people who are marginalized, people belonging to OBCs and EBCs, that if NDA comes to power, the same fate will be awaiting for them. So this is a very calculated, trained in Grand Alliance strategy, that they want to harp again and again, even when NDA is trying to raise some other issues like price rise or the issue of employment or industrialization. The Grand Alliance does not want to leave the issue of reservation, the mandalization, and what you call the politics of backward versus forward. So that's what we are seeing this time around.
Indeed. All right. Dr. Shakil, we'll have to leave it at that. Thank you so much for joining us there with all those details and putting things into perspective for us on those two issues that we discussed here on Verdict 2015. Time now for some poll snippets in our section, Poll Parade. Congress Vice President Rahul Gandhi will hold three public meetings in Bihar on October 26th. He will address two rallies in West Champaran district and one in Sitamari. Third phase goes to polls on October 28th. After much speculation about Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Bihar rallies, the Prime Minister will hold public meeting in Patna's Nawabpur block on October 25th. The BJP officials have confirmed the rally, and the city administration officials have started inspections of the venue. Lalu Prasad's RJD has the maximum number of wealthiest candidates for the third phase of elections. At least 20 RJD candidates from a total of 25 in the third phase of Bihar elections are millionaires. 26 out of the BJP's 34 candidates have also made it to the list. Well, it's time now for another short break on the program. Still to come, we throw the spotlight on Vaishali district and bring you a sense of the woes of the people of the district. That and much more on the other side. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Hello, I am Ishan Russell.
I'm Tracy Shilchi, and you're watching News Tonight.
Together with a team of our
dedicated professionals from across various fields.
This is Shyam Sundar,
Vishal Dahiya,
Akhilesh Suman,
Frank Pereira from Beijing, China,
Kriti Mishra for Rajya Sabha Television.
We bring to you
the news that matters here on Rajya Sabha TV.
Welcome back. You're watching Rajya Sabha Television. Well, Vaishali has a long association with democracy, but even after 6 decades of independence, the district is still struggling with a severe lack of development. And electors are blaming successive state governments for their plight. Here's more.
Bihar's Vaishali district, the world's first republic and the mother of all democracies. Today, it stands as a picture of neglect. A victim of broken political promises, Vaishali is awaiting answers to some basic questions like water, electricity, roads and jobs.
यहाँ पर जो भी लोग आए हैं ना ही उन्होंने आज तक शिक्षा को सुधार करने की कोशिश की. टूरिस्ट के लिए हॉस्पिटल्स जो कि बेसिक चीजें हैं वो नहीं है यहाँ पे. ट्रांसपोर्टेशन के रूप में सरकार की तरफ से कोई सुविधाएं नहीं है.
The Vaishali district has 8 assembly seats. The 2010 elections saw the BJP take 3 of these, while the JDU accounted for 5. Vaishali and Hajipur are the 2 Lok Sabha constituencies. 20 lakh voters are spread out among Vaishali, Lalganj, Hajipur, Raghupur, Mahua, Rajapakar and Patepur assembly seats.
Vaishali Vidhan Sabha Chhetra mein jo kaam hona chahiye janta ke saath, janta ke vikas ka kaam, shiksha ke chhetra mein, रोजगार के अवसर पैदा करने के क्षेत्र में किसान के खेती के क्षेत्र में वैसा कोई काम यहाँ के जो जनप्रतिनिधि रहे आज तक नहीं किए।
Contests in Mahua and Raghupur will feature Lalu Prasad's two sons. Key issues include roads, electricity, water and jobs. Apart from these, given the cultural and religious significance of Vaishali, tourism is also a big issue and so far the government hasn't done much for it.
पॉलिटिकल लोग जो भी आते हैं अपने सत्ता में आ जाते हैं, सत्ता में आने के बाद कोई ध्यान नहीं देता है, खास करके ये वैशाली जो टूरिस्ट है, आज गंदगी का अंबार है, आप देख रहे हैं सारा गंदगी फैला हुआ है, कहीं कुछ नहीं है।
The depleted third front is also determined to make its presence felt in these elections.
हमको लगता है कि वैशाली के लोगों ने मन बनाया है कि जो जातिगत यहाँ का जो वोटिंग होता था बिहार में तभी जातिगत चलेगा, लेकिन वैशाली में जो माहौल बना है उसको हमको लगता है कि लोग इस बार यहाँ के मतदाता ध्वस्त कर देंगे।
There is no dearth of political ideologies or candidates. All the voters now need is one who will work for them. Ravindra Sharon's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
A place of immense cultural and religious importance, Vaishali is looking for development as an international tourism destination. Sadly, the government so far have neglected to address this pressing need.
Every year, thousands of people arrive in Vaishali. It's the land where the Buddha first spread his teachings and where Mahavir, the founder of Jainism, was born. Pilgrims come from all over Asia, from Sri Lanka, Japan, Thailand, Indonesia, Cambodia and Vietnam. Despite this steady stream of foreigners, the facilities they find in the town are primitive and substandard.
This place is a very famous place for Buddhists. So, for the tourists, maybe it's not very convenient to stay here because it's very short facilities and accommodation for the tourists.
Devotees of Mahavira and Jainism are not lacking in numbers here.
मंदिर का जीर्णोद्धार अच्छी तरह होना चाहिए, इसलिए भी मदद करने के लिए चाहिए सरकार को, ये महावीर भगवान का जन्म स्थान है।
Dirty lanes all around, an abject shortage of public conveniences, bad roads and poor security all combine to sketch a scary scenario for any person in a strange land. The biggest problem is of course accommodation during night time. The place has immense importance. Ashanti Stupa, the Ashoka Pillar. Local residents feel a little administrative effort could go a long way in transforming it into a good tourist spot and an avenue for jobs.
टूरिस्ट यहाँ आते हैं लेकिन रुकते नहीं है, टूरिस्ट आते हैं पटना में रुकते हैं, गया में रुकते हैं, ठहराव यहाँ है नहीं। सरकार के आज तक केंद्र सरकार हो या राज्य सरकार हो, ध्यान इस वैशाली पे है ये नहीं है किसी के पास।
खाने पीने का हाँ, रेस्टोरेंट वगैरह नहीं है, होटल वगैरह नहीं है, होटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर में थोड़ा सा कमी है, तो बिहार गवर्नमेंट को, बिहार टूरिज्म को थोड़ा सा बढ़ाना चाहिए।
The voters have their priorities clear. They want the next government to transform Vaishali into a major tourist attraction. And this time, they say they will brook no compromises. Ravindra Sharan's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, that's it on this edition of Verdict 2015. See you again next time. Have a good evening.